Alright guys, welcome back to another episode of Jives Fishing. So today we are at Labrador Jetty, and the reason why now is at night but we went in the daytime is because a lot of our footage, especially when I was talking, was either corrupted or there was background music playing by some of the other anglers, and if we were to post that, we will get taken down by copyright. So I'm filming this after the actual trip. Yep, so anyway, bait for today is live prawn and frozen tamban. Yep, so we'll see how things go, update you guys again later.
Something. What is it? Oh, the handline. Got sound there, yeah, I heard. Should I hit it?
No.
Huh? Is it? I bring. He never go through the line. Oh god. This is very... hey, hold.
Starry toadfish.
Bye bye.
Okay, so that was a starry toadfish, or we just call pufferfish in Singapore. Chinese we call he tun. So they are poisonous. I have heard of some people eating them, but those are like traditional family recipes, which is highly not advised that you all try. Yeah, because if you eat the wrong thing, you can die from it. Yep, so anyway, we just let them go. It's okay. Okay, pufferfish, things to note is that they have very sharp teeth, like a beak-like teeth. I'm quite sure you can see in the video. Yeah, so usually they will go through a line or even wire. So I'm quite surprised actually those didn't actually go through our line, even though we were not using wire, it's just a mono leader. Yeah, so anyway, okay lah, I mean it's a fish, so we'll keep fishing, update you guys again later.
Puffer fish ah?
Okay, I don't know what that was. Yeah, it took our hand line and ran under the jetty, and then it got wrapped up on something. It might have been a puffer. Okay, because when I brought up my line, it was a clean cut. So usually puffer fish, they leave this very signature clean cut on your line because the teeth are very sharp. Might have been, might not have been, I don't know. Okay, but anyway, that's quite sad. Okay, we lost a fish. But well, I guess, yeah, it just happens when you're fishing. So anyway, we will keep on fishing. Now it's closer to last light-ish. Yeah, so we're going to fish into the night and we will change our bait to Geylong Sotong. Yep, so anyway, we'll update you guys again later.
Another starry toadfish. Still the puffer like.
Is it the same one?
Starry toadfish. Their teeth are very sharp, so we have to be very careful.
todak, yeah. Todak come attack my line. Sorry lah, brother.
Come on lah.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Anyway, I'm tying this rig because we are going to bait up a todak later. Okay, so what?
Yeah, a todak.
Yeah, one of the other anglers caught a todak, so they didn't want it and it's about to die, so we just go bait it up. So anyway, the first hook is tied normal snail. So the second hook, as you can see down here, is running. So what's going to happen is basically I can adjust this wherever I want. Then I can just do a loop here and it's going to stay. Yeah. So this is my adjustable hook. Then of course that it ends with another hook that is snail tied. Yeah. So two snail hooks and one running hook. Yeah. And this is a 50 pound wire and this is size 40 hooks.
Let me see the zoom out. So this is the running hook.
Yeah. This one running.
So the todak is about this length, right?
Yeah, go cut it off.
Okay. About
more than
yeah.
10 inch, 12 inch.
Okay, so experiment lor. I don't think, I don't know if there's anyone who's baited out of the todak. Let's try.
You got the thing.
Didn't want it, so it's a bit sand also, so we just use it for bait.
I'm waiting for it to completely die first. Don't want to cut it in the line.
Mine, then just hook two.
Can.
the todak after a few hours. Yeah, probably just taken by crabs and stuff. All the innards are gone.
Alright, so the todak came back and the result is that nothing touched it. Okay, except for crabs. So basically what happened was that the internal organs, the stomach, all that, they were taken by crabs. The rest of the body of the todak was actually untouched. So completely nothing looked at it, nothing even bothered about the todak. But I guess that's what happens, okay, to most of our baits, right? Sometimes you cast out even Gelong Sotong or Live Sotong, sometimes they come back and nothing has touched it at all. So I don't know if it's effective or not effective, the needlefish as bait. Okay, we will definitely try that maybe again. If we get a small needlefish, maybe we'll consider baiting it up. Yep, so if you guys have caught anything on it, yeah, do let me know. Let us know in the comments below, because I'm actually quite interested in what people can catch using needlefish. Yep, so anyway, we'll keep fishing. The bite rate hasn't been too good. Yeah, we're thinking of packing up soon. So yep, we'll update you guys again later. Alright guys, so that's the end of our short, okay, not very short, session at Labrador Jetty. Total CR for today is 2 pufferfish. Yeah, 2 pufferfish, that's all. Yeah, correct, that's all. So it was quite a weird day, honestly, I felt. Yeah, there's probably a school of pufferfish around the jetty and we happened to hook into them. Other than that, there was nothing much. It was very quiet, especially at night. I'm not very sure why. Yeah, maybe it's the tide or the weather or something. I don't know, or the fish just not hungry. So anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Yeah, hope you guys learned something maybe. And yeah, like, subscribe, let us know in the comments below what you guys have caught on todak. Okay, because I'm very, very curious. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching and hope to see you guys in the next episode.